Yes, sir.
Now, BCCI in a meeting, they have conveyed to us that they would abide by Indian law, Indian rules and regulations, and they respect Government of India's jurisdiction, Government of India's authority. And they had two or three concerns. First concern was that the quality of dope testing kit. So we assured them that the quality that we are using is of the international WADA accredited kit. They had some reservations that whether it is WADA accredited or not. So we read out with them and they agreed that yes, it is accredited with WADA. So that was the apprehension, so we removed it. And we says that in, we also said that if kit is a concern, anything which is accredited by WADA for dope testing kit, we have no issue. Okay, as it is today, that kit is approved by, it is recognized and accredited by WADA.
So
the second issue that raised is with regard to the quality of dope testing officers, dope control officers. The dope control officers are the officers who take the samples. We told them that we have our dope control officers who are well trained, who are competent. But if you need a higher qualification, then we have no issue to enlist those also, but they will be requiring higher fee. Okay. And we will not do it only for you, we will do it for all federations.
Okay. Okay.
So if you say that I only need a super specialist pathologist, we said we have no issue. If you want enhanced qualifications, we have no problem, but whatever we do will be available for everybody. Okay. I gave them an example ki Tirupati mein darshan karne jana hai. If you want that, Bhagwan to wahi hai. If you want that, you have to stand in a different queue. And you are willing to pay for it, you stand. But only you will not stand. Everybody else who is in the same category and who wants to avail the facility will be available to them. So no exclusive arrangement for BCCI. And third thing they had is the timely dispute, timely adjudication of cases.
Yeah.
We explained to them the WADA rules, World Anti-Doping Agency rules, the WADA charter, and clarified to them that, look, this gives a 3 months window and 90% of the cases are getting disposed within that. If the athlete is not asking for time or his advocate is not asking for time, we are deciding the case in less than 90 days, which is the mandated time.
Cricketers will sign the whereabouts clause. That is what has been decided, the WADA whereabouts clause. Will they be tested by NADA?
No. So yes. They, yes. Everything NADA, as and when it wants to test, it will carry out the test like it does with all other athletes.
Okay. So in all that domestic and international tournaments, look,
the WADA code clause 5.2 gives an authority to the national authority, National Anti-Doping Agency, to carry out all sort of testing in its territory, irrespective of the athlete's country. Now, all athletes, irrespective of the country of origin or country of citizenship, they come in the jurisdiction of National Anti-Doping Agency. That's the World Anti-Doping Agency's charter. And we are a partner, we are a member of that charter.
So just one for further clarification, yeah. BCCI used to get its testing done from abroad, IGTL. So now that won't happen.
The BCCI does not get its testing done by an agency outside. It is a sample taking agency they have hired, which is an outside agency. The sample taking agency is going to be an agency which is NADA.
Okay. So they've come under NADA.
I explained to them that you do not have a discretion. You don't decide whether you will follow the law or not.
Okay.
The law applies to all uniformly. India is governed by rule of law. Rule of law has two basic tenets. The first is law applies to all equally. And everybody is equal before law.
Sir, so, but then there is an issue about BCCI being a deemed recognized body.
The WADA code class 5 categorically says it applies to all athletes, all sports organizations, all sport events. So whether you call yourself a federation, you call yourself an organization, the WADA code, World Anti-Doping Agency code, very clearly says any organization, any athlete in the territory where the sport is taking place or where it resides,
so given
is in the jurisdiction of the national intervention. They have conveyed to us in writing.
So from now onwards, or is it in writing? retrospect.
Yeah.
From now onwards, whichever matches take domestic.
Yes, yes.
So one final clarification. Are cricketers were against signing the whereabouts clause. Will they now have to sign?
Every federation is on the same footing. Hmm. We don't require signing by anybody. For enforcement of law, you don't require an agreement. And we categorically told them that no agreement, no MOU, it's the law of the land that applies on all.
Right. So one okay?
And they have clarified that it applies to all.
Right. So okay? One final thing, sir, the visa issue for the South African, there was some pending issue regarding South Africa.
The point is that once we have already conveyed to them 3 days, 4 days ago, that we are for the promotion of sports and we are promotion for the sports persons. It's the ministries and the government of India's objective is very clear that it is there for promotion of sports and sports persons. Now, we are not against any sport or any athlete. We are in favor of our duty. Our mandate is to promote and protect them. Okay. Now, we have said that you commit to us in writing that from the rules and regulations promoted by government of India, you confirm that they apply and you will order honor them. They have given that.
No,
that doesn't concern the WADA and BCCI.